I welcome you back in the Big Fat Mixed Media Tribe, and this month I've decided to show you something different in my unboxing video. I have been subscribing for craft boxes for quite a long time, and I started to notice that I am not enjoying the boxes as much as I did at the beginning, simply because I already have a huge collection of cutting dies and stamps, more than I could ever use. And although I like them, I enjoy receiving the box, I understand with my rational mind that I will never be able to use what's inside the box. And then I also noticed that I mostly like the additions to the box, like different paints, inks, different pastes. So I've decided to try an art supplies box. They are not exactly meant for paper crafters, they are for artists, for painters, which I'm totally not. But I decided to give them a go and see if they make me happy or not. So I searched the internet. The art supply boxes are quite expensive, but I managed to find some which are around 20 euros. And I've decided to subscribe to this one, which is a ScrawlrBox, created by a company in UK. So let's open it. This is a January box and see what's inside. So as I said, this is a ScrawlrBox company and they have a community, and they also invite everybody who received this box to participate in a challenge and publish the images of their work. I will see, probably I will not do this, as I said, I'm not a painter, I'm not a serious artist. We'll see how it goes. So the first thing I noticed, I really like the color scheme of this box. And I guess they are suggesting the doodles. This box is created by Chris Lambert, which is a founder of this company, so I'm somehow managed to get a very special first box. The box includes this little magazine which describes the products and shows pictures of the artwork that the receivers of the previous boxes have created. It includes this notebook from Clairefontaine, and they call it a comic book. This is a really good quality paper. They do not say the weight of the paper, but it feels like 200 grams, maybe even heavier. So this might make a very good art journal, for example. An additional plus for choosing this company's box is that they plant one tree in association with Trees for the Future for every box sold. And now let's open the main part of the box, which is the little mystery packet, to see what's inside. So I guess this is the reason we subscribe to the boxes. Okay, what do we have here? Ooh, markers. Oh, candy! And do you notice that the candy actually... Oh, two candies! Two candies. Do you notice that the candies actually match the color scheme of the box? The creators of the craft boxes usually include candy. This is the first time when I see that they match the color scheme of the box. So the first I'm seeing is a black liner pen. I have quite a few of them and I use them a lot, so I'm quite happy to see one in the box. This is from Kuretake. I never heard of this company. And I'm looking forward to using the black liner and of course the markers. These are Tombow Pro markers. The colors are just gorgeous. And they have the coveted brush nib on one end. And a chisel nib on the other end. The colors are just great. The bluish color and the off-green color, just beautiful, absolutely beautiful colors. and a pencil. It's a Blackwing pencil which has been created specially for ScrawlrBox. It's an ordinary pencil, I think. I'm not very familiar with the Blackwing company. And it has a very special eraser at the end, so it's constructed a little bit differently. They say that the eraser is removable. I tried, I didn't succeed. And again, I'm just enjoying the color of the pencil. Pencil itself, the color of the wood around the pencil. So let's see how they perform. I'm starting with three markers. And I took out one page of the notebook and I'm trying the markers on them, on this page, because the box says that this is a special marker paper. And if you see, if I turn the page around, absolutely nothing seeps on the other side. So this is very interesting, for example, for card makers. You can make one layer card and use your alcohol markers, and the other side of the card will look absolutely clean and pristine and nothing will seep through. I'm using the second marker and I'm checking here if they have the color names. Now there are just numbers. I would like to know the color of these beautiful markers, especially the green one. And the blue also looks more teal blue than sky blue in real life. And the last one, the gray one, I put the marker lines on the paper. At the moment they look very streaky, but as all markers, they will wet the paper. And they will sort of, the line marks will disappear and they will blend together. I noticed that the three markers do not seem the do not feel exactly the same. The blue ones seem to be juicier than the other two. And so the box encourages you to doodle this month, and doodles are really not my thing. I have done an art journal page using doodling just once, and I cannot say that I enjoyed it. And I really admire people who can come up with doodle designs with all those scrolls and dots and lines, and I cannot do that. So I will use stamps instead of doodling myself. So I found these doodly stamps. These are flower stamps, but the designs are quite abstract, quite doodly, so I will be using those. And just stamp over the colored patches on my paper. And these stamps come from Clarity Stamp in UK. And I'm using an alcohol-friendly ink, of course. And I'm stamping on top of my colored area, the blue one. The green one. And then I realized that I probably need to choose a stamp with thicker lines. Much better. Yes. So this was my first artist box. I understand that I have not saved a lot of money, including the shipping. I probably spent what I would have spent if I bought these materials retail. However, the box justifies itself by surprising me, by pushing me outside my comfort zone, by making me trying something new, and by educating me. There are materials that I have never seen before, so I'm quite excited to have this box and looking forward to the next box. So maybe this gave you also an idea if you would like or not to subscribe to some art supplies box. I hope you enjoyed the video and I see you in the next episode. Bye bye.